Alhamdulillah, praise God. This is the great opportunity for me to once again to revise the course Sufism in India and Central Asia. I would like to just give the brief about the course which we have already completed. Today is the last day, and I know that you are eagerly waiting for this conclusion. So first we have seen that Sufism in India, and we see the Sufis enter 1000 years before in India, and we have seen that the influence of Islam, the Muslim entered in India in 711 AD under the Arab commanders Muhammad ibn Qasim, by conquering the regions of the Sindh and the Multan, and later they have come, many king came from Turkey, 1258 from the Baghdad city, also to birthplace of the Sufism with the notables, and again the Turkish commanders came, and then he also joined together 1227 AD, and his source and riches annexed from the Punjab went to the Ghazni. We have seen the Mahmud Ghaznavi, his son Subaqtagin, and he ruled and they call Ghaznavid kingdom. And then Lodis and other peoples came and they ruled, and five dynasty we seen, and these five dynasty divided, and most of they follow the Sufism, and that was the Sufism is the pioneer for the Islam in India and Central Asia. Because the orthodox Islam, or we can say mainstream Islam, failed to reach to the Indian mentality and Indian people, because the Sufism based on the song and dancing, and whereas the India is very much in dancing and singing. So this was the one of the influence. Delhi Sultanate, the empire, as come together in 1268 and 1526, and Delhi Sultanate of Raftar this time consisted, joined together, and they come together with all this group who got this all the dynasty and work for the development of education and traditional culture. And they adopted the cultures, and India was influenced by these other cultures. Well, the Muslim emperor and Muslim ruler came in India. And 1901 to 1151, Ghaznavi began to build numerous schools called Madarsa, that is called Islamic primary schools. We can say that the theological school of Islam was begin. And later they built and they grow, because they used to prefer the education, and so many scholars, ulama and faqih, we find that so many durvesh, peer and the murshid we find among them, and they joined together, and these qualified people, Sufi, they came together, made a khanqa. Our khanqa was one the center, just like an ashram. People say the khanqa brought the peoples together. Indian peoples, they start gathering together. Whenever they come to the Islam, they used to shelter them. And this was very easy to preach the Islam. So Islam is spread in India and all over the Asia. So initially the Sufi khanqa life emphasizes a close and faithful relationship between the master teacher Sheikh, because Sheikh, and the latter, we have seen that the many Hindus and other group of the peoples came to the Islam, and then Bhakti Marga started. The Bhakti movement also one of the influence moment of the Sufism, and we find that many group of them orders came one by one, because the Baghdad is the birthplace of Sufism, and Ali ibn Abi Talib is the founder of the Sufism, we can say, and along with other his friends. So there are many orders, Sufi orders, we can say, and that called Madaria Sufi orders, and that was the found in Uttar Pradesh, Modli, Kannauj, and other some of the places, and that is called Tariqa. Order means Tariqa in Arabic, and there was syncretistic aspect also. People were influenced, and now main articles we find that Shahili we find in Madurai. The Tamil Nadu Sahili peoples were there, and these Sahili peoples, they spread the Sufism all over the South India. And then we see the Chishti order. Chishti order was a bigger order and long orders. And we seen that Khaja Gareeb Nawaz Chishti in the Ajmer, and it was a very central place. Now is a lot of peoples coming from different part of the world to visit there. That's called Ziyarat. And Ziyarat means the people want to see. Ziyarat means to see, and there is people are coming. And this is the order started 940 to 441 and 1236. Even though the third king, third emperor of the Mughal, Jalaluddin Akbar, he visited three times to Mazar, Ajmer, to Khaja Gareeb Nawaz. He was the one of the murid of the Khaja Gareeb Nawaz. Khaja Gareeb Nawaz came from Iran, and many ups and down was in his life, and settled in Rajasthan, Ajmer, and that is a big mazar, the dargah today. So many Muslims from all over the world came. Even the every year many lakhs people come for ziyarat. So we have seen this order is a very big order, and not only that all the religious peoples, all religions visiting for the intention they are taking, asking and taking so many things in their heart to ask the Khaja Gareeb Nawaz, and people say that he is doing the miracles, and people are getting their answers of the prayer. So 1233 and 1236 we have seen Delhi. Many group came in this order, and this order is Chishti order. Moinuddin Chishti, Ajmer, India, Qutubuddin Bakhtiar, Khaki, and Fariduddin Ganskar, and the Pattam Pakistan, Nizamuddin Awliya, and Nasiruddin Chirag Dehlvi, and Bande Nawaz Gulbarga, South India, Karnataka, Sayyid Baqaullah Shah Karimi, and Safikur Unnao in Uttar Pradesh, Akhi Siraj in Hind, and we have seen the Dakhan, the Bengal also we found the Alul Haq, and the Pandavavi, and Ashraf Jahangiri, and Samani, and Kachhoche Sharif. We have seen this, all the people's order is still existing. Shaharwadi orders 1168, then the Kuberwaya order 1221 we find, and then we can Naqshbandiya, the main orders of this Chishti. We have seen that the most orthodox among all Sufi orthodox is the Qadariya, Abdul Qadir Jilani. We call very orthodox, and we then Sarwari Qadri, and then after that we have seen that another group of the peoples who are joined together in mention, even the Hindus and other Buddhists and the Jain, and so many groups we find that called syncretic mysticism. Islam was not a only religion in India, contributing the mystical aspect of the Sufis. The Bhakti movement also gained respect due mysticism. And popularity speaking through India. The Bhakti movement was the regional revival of Hinduism, linking languages, geography, and the cultural. And then we found the Bhakti appeared into the devotion, deity worship, and this concept of Bhakti appeared in the Bhagavad Gita, and the first sect emerged from the South India between the 7th century. They were influenced by the Sufism. Now ritual, so many ritual we say that, and these rituals, the two big ritual we can say that is the one of the